What's going on, y'all? It's TwinnyF, and I'm here with
Winter Rose from Solo Swim.
From Solo Swim, y'all heard her. You see, I had tons of yeah. Anyway, so what brings you here today?
Of course, I just had my pop-up. It's a bunch of bathing suits, different colors, different sizes, different designs. You know, you can go through any of them.
Okay.
I do custom designs. If you want to reach out to me, if we work on some, a little extra that you want just personally, we can do that. You know?
So let me ask you something. What inspired you to start the line that you have right now? Well, who inspired you?
Well, it's always been like a dream of mine to do something in the fashion industry, you know, but I just randomly wanted to do bathing suits. Like, females love bathing suits, and I feel like right now, I like the classic bathing suits. I don't want nothing with all them cutouts. Like, I'm trying to get a bomb tan line, you know, I ain't trying to do nothing extra. So I wanted to bring something, like, you know, simple, but very classy and very sexy to it.
Yeah. Can you show us something of yours? Yeah. You know, demonstrate
this. This right now, my sister ran for Miss EC, and she won, so I named this after her. It's called Miss EC. And then I have a little book right here, but I'll bring some.
Okay. So what's she doing now? She's just gonna bring a few baby suits to show y'all.
So this is just a basic black one.
Right, it's
a one piece. It's called Shade. It has like, you know, a little side out, a little back. You know, real cute, very sexy for the girls who don't want to show a lot, but a little extra in the back. You know, that's this one.
Gotcha.
This one is a high waist bottom, and it's called Girls Want to Have Funs.
Okay.
So we got the high waist bottom. Like, you know, a little basic tube top like the one I have on now.
Now, do you come up with your own color in the fabric and stuff?
I literally draw everything out myself, and I can't draw to save my life. I go out and search for the fabrics myself, like go in the stores and fill them out and everything, and I sit at my desk with my sewing machine. Me and my sister just sit in her basement, that's our little studio, and just sew and cut everything out.
Okay. Now, how long have you been doing this?
It's been a thought since like 2016, but I just started since 2017.
So I mean, if it's anybody who want to have or start their own swimwear line, what type of advice would you give them?
Don't give up, because right now in like this area, I see a lot of people kind of like trying to do the same thing, and just because they're doing it, that don't mean that you don't need to do it. Like, everybody like different things, so everybody right. brings different things. So I say, don't give up on your dream. Like, this is what you want to do, then do it.
Now, if I wanted to follow you, or anybody out here wanted to follow you on social media, go ahead, tell them your social media name so we can go out.
My personal Instagram and Twitter and everything is winter.myana, and my business page on Instagram is SoRoseSwim, so go ahead and follow that.
Y'all go ahead and follow. And before we leave, you know, go ahead and tell the people what they can expect from you in the near future with your line.
So, of course, we got SoRose Swim, but we looking forward to SoRose Lingerie and SoRose Fit. So, that's what you got coming up.
Y'all heard it loud and clear. It's 20F, and I'm here with
Winter Rose from
SoRose.
Thank you.
All right,
thank you.
Y'all, it's 20F, and I'm here with
Ms. Waza.
Y'all heard him. So, bro, what brings you here today?
You know, I'm just showing love. T-Walk pop-up shop, she hit me up on Instagram. I really like her brand and what she's doing, so she reached out and said, you know, she's trying to host something up with me. And I was all with it, you know, I had some new stuff dropping. I said, well, I got, you know, good vibes.
So, tell us the difference about the new stuff that you just dropped, you know, than the old stuff that you got.
Basically, the quality and everything is just better. I'm like really getting into a comfortable space where I got the right team around me, and you know, I got the right resources, so I'm just making the best of best quality clothing as I can right now.
Now let me ask you something. I'm pretty sure you heard of it before, or heard the question before. But what inspired you, or who inspired you to start this, you know, line?
What really inspired me was just like, I was working two jobs and my mother ain't had no job. I was helping pay a mortgage, you know what I'm saying? So
yeah.
that's what made me do it, you know, at the end of the day. But before that, it was just a watermark for my photography.
Okay.
And then my friends just kept asking me, you know, make a t-shirt. So I would say it was just like a series of unfortunate but fortunate events that just made me, you know, like really get up off my ass and make something happen for myself.
How long did you have a passion for that?
I never had a passion for fashion or clothing or none of that. Like, even when I started making the stuff, I wasn't even in the clothes. I'd probably say I got into it around like November. Like, I really started taking it serious and like studying and learning like my textiles and things like that.
Right.
That's when I started really getting into it, and like taking it serious, you know, like all the way serious. So I would say like November, but for the longest I was just stuck in like artist mode, being a photographer. I never thought I would be a designer. So like now that people put that, you know, as my title, it's crazy. So but I'm embracing it though.
So for a person who don't really, or who didn't really have a passion for fashion, you look kind of fly. What did you got on?
Oh no, see, so I get it off my, I ain't never have a passion for, but I always dress nice, because if you meet my mother, if you meet my father, those are flyest motherfuckers in the world. So I never like cared about it, but it was just natural. I would say like it was like kind of conceived, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
I've been dressing myself since I was like 5 years old, and I just always knew how to do it. But this is, damn, I'm so mad because this is a local designer, bro. This is, I'm going to text it to you, and maybe you can put it on the video. But this is a local designer, so we got to support our local designers. He made these jeans for me, some all-white jeans. So I'm about to send these to Juanito. Juanito in the area.
Juanito made those?
No, I'm about to send them to him so he can give me some things, so he can paint them, jumps. And then this is a little Stussy shirt, you know. I got my Elevate bracelet on. My mother made this joint. And yeah, you know.
Yeah,
no problem. It's a leather band. That's a genuine leather band right there. And yeah, that's just, you know, regular stuff to me, but it's fun for me to just share my style with everybody else now. So that's what I'm starting to do, like with the new drop and everything. I got some pieces where you gotta tuck your shirt in for the show and things like that.
Yeah.
And that's kind of like my style, so it feels good to, you know, like show my style or share my style with, you know, my customers or whatever.
So, you know, for other local fashion designers who just started or may want to be or get as far as you are right now, what type of advice can you give?
Start. Keep messing up. Like, start. Make all the mistakes and just keep messing up. Like, because everybody just want to, like, blueprint everything out and make sure everything right first.
Right.
Like, you just got to start. I don't care if you make 5 shirts or whatever. Like, just start. Make a name for yourself. And people only going to fuck with this half as much as you fuck with it. So, go hard. Go 200%.
So before we close out, go ahead and tell the people what they can expect from you, you know, your clothing line in the near future.
So we're going to continue to supply the DMV with the best clothing, the best designs that we can. But for me, you can expect more DJ appearances. You can expect, none of that. June 8th, we got a fashion show. I'm doing my first fashion show June 8th at the Atlas Theaters from 5 to 9. I'm doing it with Department of Youth Rehabilitation Services. A lot of people don't know this, but I got a nonprofit too. My nonprofit, I work with rehabilitated youth between the ages of 16 and 21. And I got with them, I got 15 students. We've been working for 16 weeks. And the product of all our work is coming out June 8th at our fashion show. The cool new summer, we changing the narrative on the summer. It's already been heating up, and when you from this area, when it's heating up, that's not a good thing, you know what I'm saying? So we just trying to cool it down and stay out of the way. June 8th, Atlas Theater on 8th Street, 5 to 9 p.m. That's what you can expect.
5 to 9
first,
p.m.
And this is my first fashion show, my students' first fashion show, so expect something very amazing.
June 8th, 5 to 9 p.m., his first, very first fashion show alone. All right, bro, we gone. Appreciate it.
Thank y'all, man.
What's going on, y'all? It's TwinnyF, and I'm here with
T-Walk.
Now, T-Walk, tell us what brings us here today.
What brings us here is all the bomb vendors, the whole bunch of locals that have raised their way to the top. So, it's a good experience.
Now, what is it exactly that you do, T-Walk?
Well, I'm a designer, so I design some of these pieces behind me, and that makes me support what I do.
Now, what kind of pieces did you bring with you to sell us today?
I bought bodysuits. That's mainly what I do. So this is wolf court, which is like a short jumpsuit. Like just simple.
So it has an open back space?
Yes.
Okay.
And then there's dresses, like my model here has one. Yes.
Okay. Yeah. So she's a real model.
Oh yeah. From Wisconsin, right?
Now, see, what inspired you to start, you know, your own line, or who inspired you to start this?
No one really inspired me. I love fashion. I just really wanted to do it and branch out on my own.
Now, with fashion, are there different types of fashion designers? And if so, what type of fashion designer would you say you are?
There's different types. I would say I'm more of a timeless. Like, I like things that you can still wear 20 years from now and it still be stuff.
Okay. Now, what you have on, is this your official work? Okay, can we see what you have on? Got you. Oh, so you model too?
Nah, I'm joking.
Now, see, if I wanted to be a fashion designer or anybody else, what type of advice would you give me?
So just not overthink. Just do your research and then start right away. Because the more you think about it, the longer it's going to take.
Now tell us about a flaw that you may have with, you know, designing clothes.
Flaw?
Yeah, flaw. Because not all of us are perfect like me, you know. So
I would probably say I over-design because I like to weed out, like, as I go. So maybe, I hope I answered that right.
Maybe you didn't, maybe you didn't. I don't know.
Like, if you would have said personality, I could have been like, oh, this. But, like, flaws, designing,
okay,
I don't
personality?
Know. Oh, well, you know, I was lying when I said that.
Oh, okay. You just made it sound good.
You know, made it sound good.
Okay, so let me ask you something. Do you have a favorite designer?
Too much money.
Everybody's probably Dior.
Dior?
Dior, Acne, I like. That's what he is.
What about Dior do you love?
Because it's classy. It's classy with a little bit of sexual. You know what I mean? I like it.
Now, is yours classy and sexual, or is it a little different? Oh, okay.
Exactly.
Okay. I might gotta leave. My girl's gonna kill me.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm joking. All right, so before we close out, see, you know, tell the people what they can expect from you in the near future with your products, you know, your brand.
You can expect, of course, more clothes. As the years go on, I'm really trying to expand my brand to skincare, makeup. So just be on the lookout, humbly. Be on the lookout.
Now, if I wanted to catch up with you on social media, how can I find you?
My Instagram is @TeeWalk. That's pretty much it, I swear.
In the name of your beautiful model, Rashawn, how can we find her on social media?
Hi, my name is Rashawn. My Instagram is RICHONM at Instagram.com. I said Instagram.com.
That's all good. Well, you guys, it's T and I'm 20F and we're gone. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
What's going on, y'all? It's 20F and I'm here with
Taz, Creative Company.
The boy Taz from Creative Company. So Taz, tell us what brings you here today.
I mean, today basically we're here doing a community event. It's a pop-up shop. You know, we got all the beautiful people out here. We just bringing our brand of life, man, to the people to see.
So tell us about a couple of products that you brought out today. You know, for the t-shirt, so you got faces with us.
Right, so this is the Mount Rushmore piece right here.
Uh-huh.
Face, hang it off. You can take that off. And you got the Don't Call 911 here.
Okay.
You know, this is just like a social thing right here.
Okay.
You know, with police brutality and violence.
Yeah.
You know, it's just awareness. That's what we're doing.
You said police brutality and awareness. Yeah. Right. Okay. Okay. So, you know, tell us, how long have you been doing this with police?
So we started in 2015 with a hat.
Okay.
You know, I did a hat for my man Flock. Free Flock too. Don't forget to tell us about it. So I did a hat for my man.
Uh-huh.
It went crazy.
Okay.
So after that, it flipped and I did a bulk order clothes. I got that leap of faith. Every time I got something, he bought stuff from me wholesale.
Okay.
I kept it going. I kept it flipping.
Okay.
The legal way.
Okay.
You know? So
yeah.
Now that I'm here, you know, we got orders going to Texas, California, Houston, but now we just coming to the community and bringing it to the DMV.
So what or who inspired you to start out with the hat or even clothing? What inspired you?
I mean, me and my brother, we put this together. It's just
what's your name, bro?
In the back.
Hi, Rob. Rahim. Okay, twin. Okay.
This is my business partner. We're the CEO of the company.
Okay.
So it's just like we always had a mix of fashion to stand out. So we just bringing the business to life. You know, just giving it something different, something that they can feel.
Okay. So. What is something that people can expect from you all or you two in the near future with
quality.
Your clothing line?
Quality.
High fashion.
Okay.
You notice the high fashion doing what we doing.
Okay.
We've been doing.
Okay. Okay.
Balenciaga, Prada, they making street clothes. They making tennis shoes. They making t-shirts. They want to do what we doing.
Yeah.
So we gonna get after them.
Okay. So before we go, you know, tell the people where they can find you guys on social media, where they can follow you.
Y'all can do it like this. Official Tissue. Always actively building boundaries and creating company. www.creating.company. Creating Company on Instagram. You can follow me at Tab the Great. Follow my man at OZ Haynes. Instagram. There.
Y'all heard him loud and clear, man. It's 20F, and I'm here with Free and the Company. We gone. Appreciate it, bro.
Straight up.
Appreciate it, bro. Appreciate y'all. Kara Marie, you guys heard her loud and clear. No, Kara, let me ask you something. What brings you here today?
I just thought that today would be a good networking event so everyone could get to see the amazing products that I provide. I just love how everyone is just so friendly here, and I knew Kara, so I thought, you know, like, why not support her?
Now, tell us a little bit about the products that you have here that you're selling today.
Well, I sell wigs and I sell hair. I also sell swimsuits. I just expanded my business and started selling those, and I sell garments as well. Do you mind if I show them?
Yeah, show us the stuff that you got.
This is one of the wigs that I'm selling today. It's a pink wig. It's called Bubblicious. It's a very good wig. Wigs are amazing for protective styles. Anyone that just wants to feel like a new them every day, you know. And then, these are toy suits that I just started selling, which are really good for girls that like looking hippie. This is what the top looks like. These are 20.
So it's easy to snap on and off.
These are both of my bonnets. This is real popular because this is good for girls with like long hair that don't want to have like bends in their straight hair and stuff like that. And these are the short ones.
So this is a bonnet, right? I thought this was a bag.
Yeah, it's a bonnet. It's real good for like people with straight hair, braids, dreads, things like that.
Now let me ask you something, Kara. What inspired you, or who inspired you to start, you know, with the products that you have, with the line that you have to sell?
Actually, my friend did. She asked me to make her a wig one day, and everybody loved it after I made it for them. And then I thought, like, once people started coming to me, like, asking, oh, can you make me a wig, can you make me a wig? I was like, I'm going to have to make this into a business and, you know, really start getting some money from it. And then I expanded it and started selling other things as well.
Now, how did you know how to make a wig?
YouTube. I learned from YouTube. And just doing it, you know, when you
now, if it's anybody who wanted to, you know, start making wigs or have a swim line.
Sorry to cut you off, but I actually have one-on-one classes for something like that.
Yeah.
Just to make wigs, not to like sell clothes, nothing, just because I'm new doing that as well. But as far as wigs, I got that.
Okay. Now, as I was saying, so if it's anybody who want to start their own swim line or making wigs, what type of advice would you give them?
Just to keep practicing. Making wigs is way better than doing sewing or doing regular hair because they don't have to be right there in front of you. So if you can mess up as many times as you want, but practice makes perfect. Just keep trying.
So if I wanted to find you on social media, or anybody out here wanted to find you on social media, what's your social media name to get?
My Instagram is Kara Marie Services, LLC, and that's all I'm going to go down. And I also have a website, which is www.karamarieservices.com.
Thank you so much, Kara. What's going on, y'all? It's 20F, and I'm here with
Suki.
Now, Suki, tell us what brings you here right now.
To expose my brand. I just started my brand about a year ago, so just to get it out there, keep getting it out there.
Now, what type of products do you have to sell?
I sell all handmade bags. Everything is made by me.
Okay, and how long have you been doing this?
I started this business in August, so over a year.
What inspired you to start this business?
Just because I know how to sew and I love bags. I have a ton of bags before I started this business, so you know, I was curious to figure out how to make one. And this was something that I love to do.
Okay, and earlier when I was talking to you, you were telling me about the different material with like plastic, iron,
right.
Different fabric materials. So just tell us a little bit more about it.
So the different fabrics take well to different things. You want to know how I choose the fabric?
Let's go.
So, I mean, I choose the fabric based off the color that I like for today. Everything is inspired by color to me. I love color. I love different things. So that's pretty much how I get my inspiration.
So let me ask you something, like with this bag here,
how
did you make it like holographic? Like how did you make it this color?
The material came like that.
Oh, what type of material is it?
This is, it's iridescent, but the fabric under is like a rain fabric, so it's waterproof.
And how much does this go for?
$25.
Only
$25? Only $25.
Man, y'all heard her, Suki with 20F. She got products as low as $25, and thank you so much.
Thank you.
See you soon. What's going on, y'all? It's 20F, and I'm here with
Mike Hale, CEO of Woody Studio Design, the Delaware streetwear brand, Mold and Runway and Streetwear Fashion.
So what brings you here today, bro?
here to enjoy this beautiful moment with all my people.
Okay. Now tell us a little bit about your product and the authenticity about your product, and you know what makes it different from everybody else's wear.
What is Pluto Design is the heart of the streets. Anybody that makes any real money, you will see them in What is Pluto.
Okay.
That's it.
Well, now what's real money?
Real money, status, the guns and butter, meaning not like clothes and shoes, like money.
Okay. Now what inspired you to start the clothing line that you got right now?
I had a couple inspirations. Future, Scarface, just coming up in DC for real.
What about Scarface you like?
The rise of power.
Uh-huh.
And not letting your ego put you in a spot that you can't get out of.
Okay. Okay, and how long have you been doing this?
2.5 years. I actually went to school for fashion design.
You went to school?
Yeah.
What school did you go to if you don't mind telling
me? I went to UDC, but I wanted to go to FIT, so.
What's FIT?
Fashion Institute of Technology.
Is it in New York?
Yeah. It's one of the top schools.
Yeah, I think I heard of it. So, you know, if people wanted to follow you or catch up with you on social media, where can they find you?
If you want to follow me on social media, you can find me making rants every day. I'm just kidding. And Mr. What is Pluto or What is Pluto Design?
All right, well, y'all heard the man. It's 20F, and I'm here with
Mike Hill, What is Pluto?
All right, and we gone. Appreciate it, bro. I'll be back over here, all right?
That's it.